Rambanese Primary School would like to acknowledge the traditional owners of this land which we are gathered,
and we pay our respects to the elders both past and present.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to our last online assembly for the 2017 school year. It's just amazing. I can remember sitting here at the start of the year filming the online assembly. Well, firstly, a big thank you to all our students for your work last week in presenting some outstanding performances at the Christmas Carols concert. I must give out a very special thank you to all your teachers for your support. Special thank you to Mrs. Dunwall for her organisation, and also to our very special Mr. Beach for the wonderful job he did in emceeing on the day. And a very special thank you to all the parents who came along to support our children. A lot of smiling faces, and that's one of the reasons why we do these things. So thank you, everybody. Well, this week we've had the Fluoro Fun Run, and I know a lot of children had lots and lots of fun. So congratulations. Well done, children. Great to see you all dressed up around the school. And just a reminder to get all those donations into the school, because with that money we're going to be purchasing more interactive TVs for the learning spaces. Also, last week, Mr. Beach and Mrs. Purvis took our choir on some visits in the community. I must say, again, congratulations, students in our choir. Feedback we received is absolutely outstanding. Your performance on the day at the venues was very much appreciated. Well, this week also we've had our year six and also our year prep, our foundation year orientation days. I know the children have been really excited, especially our year sixes as they prepare to move on to secondary college. And talking of year six, this week, we will be celebrating the year six graduation ceremony, and that's this evening. I know it's going to be a wonderful event to mark 7 years of primary school. And a big congratulations, students, because you are our very first, what we call cohort group, to start off in prep since we opened and move through to graduation in year six. Looking forward to the night tonight. I know it's going to be a lot of fun, a lot of celebrations. My next point is just a very big thank you to all our students and families for your contribution to the Christmas Basket Appeal that we support Bunnings through this time every year. The baskets again this year are absolutely overflowing, and I know there's going to be many, many grateful, appreciative parents and families out in the community, and it's just one little way that we can say, you know, thank you. All right, well, in closing, I would just like to send out a special thank you to our students for the wonderful effort that you put into your learning. Everything you've done at school this year, it's been some many, many, many exciting times. And I know many of our students will walk away at the end of the year with some very fond memories of some of the learning and some of the fun times they've had at school. A very special thank you to our teachers for all that hard work, those long hours you put in. A special thank you to our integration aides who support our students with that special care every day at school. Thank you to our office staff and everybody else that supports me in running the school. And finally, families, look, again, thank you for your support in the things you do, you know, supporting your children at home with the learning, attending camps and excursions and coming into the schools to support reading activities, and the list goes on. Well, everybody, have a wonderful, wonderful break. For our students that are leaving us at the end of the year, I wish you every success. And to our new families, a very special welcome. But have a very safe, very restful Christmas holidays. Have lots of fun, everybody. And we look forward to seeing you back at school next year.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the final Mrs. Wrigley's Riddle for 2017. It's been a very great year, and I can't wait for you to hear my final riddle. Are you ready? Where does Santa put his suit after Christmas? 10 seconds thinking time, see if you can work this one out. Alright, thinking time is over. Alright, let's see how you went. Where does Santa put his suit after Christmas? In the closet. Did you get it? Well done if you got that one right. Great thinking. And that is now it for the year. We'll see you all again next week at our whole school assembly in the gym. Have a wonderful week, everyone. Bye now.
George the Sunsafe Superstar by Catherine Clifford and Chantel Wren. This is the story of how a boy became known by a very, very special name. How he spread a message near and far and became a Sunsafe Superstar. It began one day when his mummy said, "When you go out, George, use your head. Remember, son, to slip, slop, slap. Wear a t-shirt, sunscreen and a hat. When it's sunny, you must think that these will stop you turning pink. The sun is fun and good for you, but it can burn and hurt you too. It is important that you know, whilst it gives us light and makes things grow, the sun sends out invisible rays that can burn your skin on sunny days. Unlike a burn from normal heat, sunburn harms the skin beneath. It can make you very sore, so be certain and make sure you cover shoulders, shade your head, and apply your sunscreen," his mummy said. George asked, "How can something I can't see hurt my skin and damage me?" Mum said, "It's a harmful form of light that's called UV and is out of sight. Like lots of things that are in the air that we can't see but are still there. The sun is hottest around midday, so find a shady place to play. Be extra careful between 11 and 3 when the sun produces strong UV. Find some shade under a tree or go indoors for a while maybe. A tip that's really good to know is to look down at your shadow. If your shadow is shorter than you, slip, slop, slap is what to do. Another tip that's very wise is to wear sunglasses to protect your eyes." George knew that he'd look really cool if he followed the Sunsafe rule. "To help remember it," his mummy said, "just think 5 S's in your head. Slip, slop, slap, that makes 3. Plus sunglasses and shade makes 5, you see." So on that sunny summer's day, before George went outside to play, he slipped on his t-shirt, slopped on his sunscreen, slapped on his hat, easy as that. Remembering what his mum had said, he popped his sunglasses on his head. His mum said proudly, "George, you are an official Sunsafe Superstar." The following day, George went to school, where a year 6 boy who's really cool was playing football in the midday sun without his hat or sunscreen on. The boy was slowly turning red as the sun beat down upon his head. Slip, slop, slap, George said. Slip on a t-shirt, slop on the sunscreen, slap on a hat. As simple as that. The only thing you need to learn when playing outside is never burn. Follow these rules and you'll know you are, like me, a sunsafe superstar. Thanks, said the boy. I didn't think the sun could burn and turn me pink. For a little kid, you've a clever head. Like a superhero, the big boy said. Now I know I can pass it on to someone else who loves the sun. So spread the message near and far until we're all a sun-safe superstar. George thought about what the boy had said and how he could make the message spread. So he told his friends, he told his school, he told them all the sun-safe rule. He told them all to pass it on, and soon he had told everyone. George was pleased. He told his mum. He told her all that he had done and told her how he'd now become known by his school and everyone as not just George, age 5, class R, but George the sun-safe superstar.
Hi, I'm Sahath, one of the Donnelly House Captains for 2017. This week's house points are in fourth place, Ruffy with 1,235 points, Hudson in third with 2,170 points, Lyle in second with 3,555 points, and Donnelly first with 5,181 points. This week's Rubbish Free Lunch winners are 3SW with an average of 4.3. Rubbish Free Prize winner is Gubbin Beer.
Slip, slop, slap, seek and slide, have fun outside, but don't get fried. Slip on a shirt, slop on sunscreen, slap on a hat, seek shade, slide on sunnies, simple as that. Slip, slop, slap, seek and slide, have fun outside, but don't get fried. Slip, slop, slap, seek and slide. Slip, slop, slap, seek and slide, have fun outside, but don't get fried. Slip, slop, slap, seek and slide.